Alright, what's up? Welcome to Hooson. In this video, we will be learning how to make an energy system. Before we make our energy system, remember to click on the subscribe button for more Unity tutorials and game development videos. Alright, let's jump right into it. Let's set up our energy UI first. Create an empty game object under canvas and let's name it energy. Now we need an energy bar, so create a new slider under our energy game object and rename it to energy bar. Resize it to your preferred size. And we will delete the handle slide area as we won't be using it. Let's change the fill color, and I'm going to use a yellow color for it. You can use any color you want. Alright, now let's click on our energy bar and increase the value to 1 just to make sure that the fill area covers the entire bar. As you can see, there's still a little gap, so click on the fill area game object and let's resize it. Okay, perfect. Now, let's create a text under our energy game object and rename it to energy text. Scale it to your preferred size and let's change the text to 25/25. This text is going to indicate how much energy the player has left. Now, we need to let the players know how much time is left for our energy to refill. So create another text under our energy game object, resize it, and we will call it timer text. Let's change the text to something like 10 minutes, and we will place it right below our energy bar. Lastly, let's create a button under our energy game object, and rename it to use energy button. I'm going to resize it, and place it somewhere below. Okay, we are done setting up our energy UI, and it's time to do some coding. Create a new C# script called energy. We can go ahead and delete the update function as we won't be using it. And at the top, we want to add the UnityEngine.UI namespace and system namespace. We are adding these namespaces because we will be using the text and datetime variable type. Using the serialized fill attribute, we will create two text variables called energy text and timer text, and a slider type variable called energy bar. We use the serialized fill attribute when we want our variable to be private, but also want it to show up in the editor. Now, let's create three private integers called max energy, current energy, and restore duration. I will give the max energy a value of 25 and restore duration a value of 5 for now. Create two private date time variables called next energy time and last energy time. Lastly, a private boolean called is restoring, and let's set it to false. Alright, there are three variables that we need to save: current energy, next energy time, and last energy time. So a simple way to store and assess player preferences between game session is by using player prefs. Create a new private function called load and a private function called save. In the save function, we will use the setInteger static function to save our current energy as it is of type integer, and use the setString static function to save our next energy time and last energy time variable. So you must be wondering, our next energy time and last energy time variable are of type dateTime. Why are we saving them as a string? The reason is because it is only possible to save values of type float, integer, and string in player prefs. Therefore, we need to save these two variables as of type string. Now in our load function, we will use the getInteger static function to retrieve our current energy data. Alright, here comes the tricky part. As I said earlier, we save our next energy time and last energy time data as of type string. So when we load our data again, we need to convert them back into type dateTime. So let's create a private dateTime and we will call this function stringToDate. Under the stringToDate function, if our string is null, we want to return dateTime.now, which means we are just returning the current time. Else, we will pass our value of type string into dateTime. Let's head back to our load function and we will call the stringToDate function to convert our value of type string into type dateTime. Alright, we are able to load and save our energy now. Next, we need to be able to update our energy bar, energy text, and energy timer. So let's create two new private functions called updateEnergy and updateEnergyTimer. So under the updateEnergy function, we will assign our energy tags to be equals to currentEnergy / maxEnergy. EnergyBar.maxValue equals to our maxEnergy and EnergyBar.value to be equals to our currentEnergy. Head over to the updateEnergyTimer function and we want to check if our current energy is more than or equals to our max energy. And if it is, we will set our timer tags to full. So what if the energy isn't full and the timer is running? We will use the time span object to calculate the interval between our next energy time and current time. Which means if our next energy time is at 11 a.m. and our current time is at 10:50 a.m. player got to wait 10 minutes to gain an energy. Alright, let's format it into minutes and seconds. And we will set our timer tags to be equals to time value. Now let's create a private date time and we will call it addDuration. This function will be called when we want to increase the duration of our timer. So I'm going to use the addSeconds method for demonstration purposes. In your actual game, I don't think you will be using add seconds as it is a little too fast, so games that uses the energy system usually add minutes instead. But this is just a tutorial, so I'm not going to wait a few minutes just to see if my codes are working well. So I will use the add seconds method instead. Next up, we will create a new coroutine called restore energy. Firstly, we will call the update energy timer function, and then we will set is restoring to true. Next, we will do a loop to check if our current energy is less than our max energy. So this restore energy coroutine will keep running as long as the current energy is less than the max energy. Inside the loop, we will need to create two date time variables. We will set current date time to be equals to dateTime.now and next date time to be equals to next energy time. Lastly, create a boolean called isEnergyAdding and we will set it to false. We need to do another while loop to check if the current date time is more than the next date time. The reason why we are doing this is because we might be adding more than one energy as long as the current energy doesn't exceed the max energy. So if the current energy is less than the max energy, we will set isEnergyAdding to true and increase the current energy by 1 and call the updateEnergy function. Now, we need to create another date time variable and let's call this timeToAdd. This variable will be used to identify which time we are adding the duration to. So we will check if our last energy time is greater than our next energy time. And if it is greater, we will be using the last energy time value. Else, we will be using the next date time value. Now, we will set our next date time to be equals to add duration, and we will put the time to add variable and restore duration inside. Else, we will just break the coroutine if the current energy is equals or more than our max energy. So now, we need to check if there's any changes to our energy. If isEnergyAdding equals equals to true, we will set our last energy time to be equals to dateTime.now and next energy time to be equals to next date time. After the checking is done, we need to update the energy UI, so let's call the updateEnergyTimer function and updateEnergy function. We need to save our data as well, so let's call the save function and we will need to execute the timer every frame to keep the timer running. Lastly, we will need to set isRestoring back to false. Let's head over to the start function and we will check if there's any saved data from the previous game session. If there's no data to retrieve, we will set the current energy to 25, which is our max energy. Next, call the load function and restore energy coroutine. Else, if there's saved data from the previous game session, we will just call the load function and restore energy coroutine. Last but not least, we will need to create a useEnergy function for our useEnergy button. So firstly, check if the current energy is more than or equals to 1. If it is, we will minus 1 from our current energy and call the updateEnergy function. Next, check if isRestoring equals equals to false. And then check if current energy plus 1 equals equals to max energy. If it is, we will set the next energy time to be equals to add duration and we will put the dateTime.now and restore duration inside. Next up, call the restore energy coroutine. Lastly, if the current energy is less than 1, we will just debug .log insufficient energy. save the script, and head back to Unity. Attach the energy script to our energy game object, and we will assign our energy text, timer text, and energy bar to it. Click on our use energy button, and we want to call the use energy function when we click on the button. Alright, it's time to give it a try. Your energy system should start at the maximum energy because there isn't any previous game data. Let's click on the use energy button to see if our energy system is working perfectly. Alright, nice, it stops when the energy is full, and let's see if it saves the current amount of energy. Alright, perfect. So your game now has an energy system, and it will work even if the player exits the game and isn't playing. Because what happens is that the next time the player enters the game again, the energy script will take into consideration how much time has passed and will update the energy accordingly. This energy system isn't perfect by any means, because we are getting dead time from the player's device. So the player can cheat by changing the time on their device. If you want to prevent that, you have to get the time from the internet instead. But of course, the advantage of not using internet time is that your game can be played offline, and at least there's an energy system in your game. So that's all for this video. Do click the like and subscribe button if you enjoyed this video. I will be posting more Unity tutorial and behind the scene of my game dev journey in the future as well. Also, do check out my first ever mobile game that I published for Android and iOS called Bot Attack. Link to download Bot Attack will be in the description below. I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.